Time now for Rocky Jordan. Not far from the Mosque Sultan Hassan in Cairo stands the Cafe Tambourine, run by Rocky Jordan. The Cafe Tambourine, crowded with forgotten men, alive with a babble of many languages. For this is Cairo, where modern adventure and intrigue unfold against a backdrop of antiquity. Tonight's story, The 2 o'clock Man.
It was around 5 minutes till 2 o'clock in the morning. I was in bed trying to catch up on some sleep when I heard noises out front. I rolled over, ready to forget the whole thing, when the sound became too loud and too familiar. I slipped on a pair of trousers and headed for the bar. It was dark, but not empty. Somebody was playing Halloween out of season. From somewhere behind the bar, I could hear his breathing as he scratched around on my register. I moved around the end of the bar toward the short, panting breaths. Then he saw me and made a dart. You're going no place, buddy.
Let me go. Let me go.
Sure, buddy. You're going. Out. I hit him and he crumbled like arches on a fat man. I flipped on the light to see what he looked like. He was small and wiry. He wasn't Egyptian or Arab or European, but he seemed like a mixture of all. He coughed a couple of times and then sat up. His big black eyes stared angrily at me, and I could see that he was very young.
You are pig. Infidel.
All right, sonny. Sorry I hit you. Come on, up on your feet.
Let me go. I can get up myself.
Come on, kid. What's your name? What are you doing here?
My name is Joseph, and it is obvious what I do here.
Yeah, I guess it is. But you're not very smart about it. People don't leave money in their cash registers at night. That's what they got safes for. Well, what do you think I ought to do with him?
Whatever you wish. I am not afraid.
You're too old to be spanked and too young to be slapped. You know, you ought to give up this second story work while you're still an amateur. It's got no future.
I will worry about my own future.
You're not very talkative, are you?
I am of the sacred family of El Rakam. I do not talk to infidels.
Great, but you steal from them.
That is my business.
It's mine, too, when you start picking the tambourine.
Talk, talk. Do with me what you will and stop talking.
Look, sonny, I've seen kids like you all over the world, starting with a little petty snatching and winding up in
jail. You are a pig!
Why, you little...
Anun Ra's neck, pa. You will die.
Sure, we all will. Now, come on.
Where do you take me?
Someplace where you'd have a chance to brush up on your manners. The police station. Inside half an hour, we pulled up in front of the Cairo police station and got out. Joseph, member of the sacred family of El Rakam, whoever he was, hadn't spoken. We went inside. Sergeant Greco, underling to Captain Sam Sabaaya, was sitting behind the desk, dozing. When he heard us come in, he snapped to life real fast and became very official.
Oh, Mr. Jordan, I was not expecting you.
Yeah, I could see that. Did you have a pleasant dream?
I was not sleeping. I was simply resting my eyes.
Yeah, sure. Bet she was a brunette.
Will you please show some respect for a servant of the people? Now, what may I do for you, Mr. Jordan?
You can get me Sam.
Captain Sabaaya has had a very difficult evening. He is very tired. He is preparing to leave for his home this very moment. What may I do for him?
I told you, get me Sam.
Mr. Jordan, I have just...
I got someone I want him to meet.
This boy?
Yes, this boy. Now turn up Sam for me, or do I have to go in and get him myself?
What is going on out here, Sergeant?
It is Mr. Jordan.
Jordan, what are you doing here this time of night?
Business, Sam.
He has brought this boy for some reason. I told him, Captain, that you are too
yes,
tired
yes,
to...
Yes, 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 Sergeant. Yes. That is enough. Now, what is it you want, Jordan?
Sam, I caught this boy doing a one-man floor show at the tambourine about an hour ago.
Jordan, I am not interested in your entertainment problem.
You will be, Sam. This kid dropped in after hours on his own. I found him scratching around my cash register.
Oh, I see. What is your name, young man?
You're a pig, too. I...
What? Of all the...
I forgot to tell you he had a nasty habit like that.
Never mind. If he does not choose to talk, we can wait. Sergeant.
Yes, Captain.
Lock this youth up until morning. We will interview him then.
Yes, Captain. Come along, boy.
You do not have to push.
Now, come along, boy.
Hands off of me.
I wanted you, Sam, because I didn't want to leave the kid in Greco's hands. He's overeager.
Yes, Jordan, I know what you mean. You do not like taking children to police stations, do you, Jordan?
What do you think?
I think that I am very tired.
He said he was a member of the sacred family of El-Rakam. That mean anything to you?
El-Rakam? No, it does not. But suppose we discuss this young man's family tree in the morning.
Oh, but Sam...
Jordan, you are concerned for nothing. This boy is what you Americans refer to as a juvenile delinquent. There is nothing more to it. Now, please go home and get some sleep so that I may do the same.
Yeah, I'll do that. Good night, Sam. I walked out of the police station and started up the street. I'd taken just about 6 steps when I heard it. It started from somewhere inside the police station and sounded like a cyclone on a weekend spree. By the time I'd taken a few more steps, the door of the police station flew open and Joseph came running out fast like a super chief on a holiday weekend. He darted toward the corner full blast, and Sam and Sergeant Greco came running 10 paces behind him. I followed. We were halfway to the end of the block when the kid turned the corner. The three of us stepped up our pace, turned the corner after him, and Greco pulled his gun. Before I could yell at him, the thunder broke. The kid dropped to the sidewalk and was still. When we got to him, Sam bent over to look. Joseph, member of the sacred family of El-Rakam, was dead.
Torture! There was no need to shoot!
Since when does the Cairo Police Department shoot down kids?
But, Captain, I did not shoot the boy.
What?
I did not shoot him. Look, my gun. All the shells are there. It has not been fired.
Let me see that. That's right, Greco. All the bullets are here.
There you are. Now, might I suggest, Captain, that since I did not shoot him, and since you did not even draw your gun from the holster, we examine Mr. Jordan...
You know I don't carry a gun, Sam.
We know no such
thing. Sergeant, you will call the coroner and you will arrange for the photographer to take some pictures of this scene. We will begin an investigation immediately.
Yes, Captain.
And you, Jordan, go home.
Look, I brought the kid here. You don't wish me off that easy.
Jordan, this is no affair of yours. The Cairo police will do everything possible to unearth the killer.
I don't like going to bed with a dirty taste in
my mouth. Jordan, this is an order. Now leave at once. We do not need your help.
Maybe not. But you may be getting it anyway. I left, headed back to the Cafe Tambourine, and went to bed. But I didn't sleep. The sight of Joseph, a fresh kid, crumbled in the street, stayed with me. It was a long night. I got up around 9 and had breakfast, but the strange death of Joseph was like too much salt in my eggs. Along about 10 o'clock, Chris, my bartender, told me there was a visitor in my office to see me. I went over and opened the door. The smell of Emir caught me. She was blonde and tall and slim, except where she shouldn't be. She was wearing a white linen suit and a white hat. And it was all there. All very nice.
So, you are Mr. Jordan?
I didn't get your name.
The name is Ilya Renault.
Oh. What can I do for you?
It is not what you can do for me, Mr. Jordan. It is what you have already done.
I'm afraid you'll have to start over.
A young boy, was murdered last night. In case you don't remember, Mr. Jordan. And it seems pretty clear to me you are responsible.
Hey, now, wait a minute.
I will not wait for your lies and your feeble excuses. There is no alibi for murder. A boy was killed needlessly. And their blood is on your hands.
Hey, hold on there. I'll admit I feel at least partially responsible, and the whole thing was pretty unfortunate.
Unfortunate? But... Oh, yes, unfortunate. That is your only answer.
Where do you fit into this?
Where I fit. Mr. Jordan, that boy, Joseph, was my brother. My half-brother.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Renault.
If you had not taken poor Joseph to jail, if you had
What if he hadn't broken into my cafe? Have you thought of that?
I'll admit the boy was wrong. Joseph was not himself. He was not a bad boy. These past few months, we had grown so far apart. He behaved so strangely. Nevertheless, you are not vindicated in having him murdered.
Joseph was not shot by the police. He was not shot by me. He was killed by a person or persons unknown in the official language of the police.
And I suppose that makes it all very proper and usual.
Look, both the police and I would like very much to know who killed Joseph. Captain Sabaaya will do everything he can to find the murderer.
And you, Mr. Jordan, What about you? What are you doing? Just as I thought, nothing. Except being sorry.
Miss Renault, perhaps you have an idea who might have wanted to kill Joseph.
No, I have no idea. Joseph and I were never that close. His father divorced my mother many years ago. Joseph's mother was an Egyptian noblewoman. For the past several years, I've been in France. Then I moved back to Cairo to take care of Joseph.
Doesn't it seem strange to you that he'd turn to a robbery? That he'd break into my cafe at 2 o'clock in the morning?
Of course it does. I told you it was not like him. I just cannot understand what made him do it.
You're not much help.
Then you are going to do something. You really are interested.
I sort of have to be, don't I?
Oh, thank you, Rocky. Please, forgive me for misjudging you, for saying the things I did.
You ought to hear what some other people say about me.
I'm living at 65 Sharia Nefar.
Well, I'll let you know when I get something definite.
She left, and later in the day, I had visitor number two. A man I wanted very much to see. His name was El Rakam. He was tall, lean, and dark. He wore purple robes and a silver chain with a fancy emblem around his neck. And he had a muscle man with him.
Peace be unto you, noble sir. My card.
Oh, thanks. Have a seat.
My assistant is known as the Turk. He will join us.
Yeah, sure, Jim. Sit down, gentlemen. Oh, what's on your mind?
My name, as you know, is El Rakam, master of all that is worthy, leader of the new light, bestower of the sacred learning.
Your card doesn't say all that.
Mr. Jordan, a member of my sacred family was slain early this morning. I understand you were present at this deplorable occurrence. You would tell me how you are involved and exactly what you have done. Do I make myself clear?
Joseph was one of your boys?
Joseph was a member of the sacred family of Rakam, a disciple in the way of the advanced learning.
You call breaking into the tambourine advanced learning?
Mr. Jordan, I shall try to be patient. When a member whom I hold in high esteem dies, I must have the complete knowledge of his death.
Okay, the boy was shot trying to escape the police. Only the police didn't kill him. They don't know who did.
And this you call the complete knowledge?
Yeah.
Mr. Jordan, these facts I have learned from the police myself. I would like to know your connection, please. Also, why you found it necessary to take Joseph to jail.
Look, Rakam, I've told you all I know. I'm a busy man. Maybe you better talk to somebody else.
Mr. Jordan, I had hoped I would not have to come to this. However, you obviously refuse to cooperate. It is the desire of El Rakam and his followers that all matters be settled in peace. Violence is barbarian and uncivilized. Yet you force me to act. When El Rakam acts, the world can fear the repercussions.
You're a pretty big man, Rakam, according to you. Far too big to waste your time talking to mere peasants like Rocky Jordan.
Mr. Jordan, I hold you responsible for the death of a member of my family. There is no greater crime, and the punishment is quick and certain. Heed well my words.
Okay, Rakam, take your words and get out. You're disturbing my customers.
As I am Rakam, leader and omnipotent head of the sacred family, as I am this and more, so shall you, Mr. Jordan, so shall you die to avenge the death of Joseph.
You are listening to The 2 O'Clock Man, tonight's adventure with Rocky Jordan. If you like radio mystery, thrilling stories, exciting characters, and the kind of suspense that keeps you absorbed until the final gripping moment, you'll want to spend your radio listening time with CBS. Because at the CBS spot on your dial, you'll find that kind of mystery. Now we take you back to Cairo and tonight's adventure with Rocky Jordan, the 2 O'Clock Man.
It all began when somebody shot down a kid who I had turned over to the police for breaking into my cafe tambourine. Then a couple of people showed, saying I was responsible. The kid's sister, Ilya, and a guy who called himself El Rakam. That joker was thirsting for revenge. Well, El Rakam and his silent sidekick, the Turk, made a grand-type exit out of my office. Just outside the door, they were joined by two burly-looking bodyguards who could have passed for the Tarzan twins. Then the four of them marched out of the cafe. As far as I was concerned, El Rakam, spelled backwards, was phony. And it also spelled answers to questions concerning murder. I decided to follow. It was as easy as tailing an elephant in a clothes closet. The purple robes drifted down Sharia El Reis, turned left three blocks up, and entered the lobby of the Hotel Continental. The two bodyguards split off, and El Rakam and the Turk took the elevator to the fifth floor. I waited and caught the next car. The trail ended before a door marked 505. I was debating my next move when suddenly the door opened.
Come in, Mr. Jordan. We have been expecting you.
Standing in the doorway was 6 feet four of man, El Rakam's right-hand man, the Turk. I went inside. He was there alone.
You were a fool to be trapped so easily, Jordan. You were led here as one might lead a sheep for slaughter.
Maybe, friend. Time will tell.
No, the time is now. We will teach you to murder.
The big man was on top of me like a tent in a windstorm. His hands grasped at my throat and his fingers dug in. I gave him a kick and another one, but the fingers dug in deeper. I was seeing red and then blue and then purple. I brought my knee up and caught him in the belt. He rolled back from me. Then a shiny object came flying into the room. Turk doubled up, grabbed at his middle and pitched forward to the carpet. Everything got suddenly quiet, like visitor's day at the morgue. I bent over him. He was dead. Protruding from his stomach was a knife, an ordinary kitchen knife, but one I'd seen before. It was from the Cafe Tambourine. Oh, it was too perfect, too well set up to stick around. Everything neat and in place for Rocky Jordan to take the rap. It took me 2 minutes to decide where to go next. A guy named Bill Morley, a reporter at the Cairo Record, might be of some help. Inside of 10 minutes, I was sitting across from him at his desk.
Nothing but trouble when you walk in here, Rocky. What's up?
You know most of the characters in this town, Bill. I need some information about one of them.
Yeah?
Name's El Rakam, the sacred family of Rakam. You know him?
Know him? I wouldn't touch him with a 10-foot pole. He's dynamite.
Oh, why?
Look, Rakam arrives in town a couple of months ago. One of the papers gets a front-page interview with him. They play him for all he was worth. And what happened? Rakam slapped a $1 million libel suit on him. And he'll probably collect.
He doesn't like publicity?
Wants no interference at all. Not like the rest of these phonies who do anything to get their photos on a big spread. This guy works in the dark, and he does better that way.
That's all you know about him?
Well, what he's got isn't a new religion or even vaguely connected with it. It's pure mystic and pure hokum. He just talks to the customers and they shell out. They never know what hit him.
That good, huh?
The 2 o'clock man is darn near perfect.
What'd you call him?
2 o'clock man. That's what the papers have labeled him. He holds his meetings in an old temple at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Nobody has anything on him?
Well, just once. They got a picture of him and a kid during a riot in Alexandria a few months ago. Cop was killed. El Rakam had a gun.
That sounds almost too good. What happened to it?
Yeah. Take a look yourself. You'll see why nothing happened.
I see what you mean. Everything about it points to El Rakam.
Except he happened to have his back turned. Sure, it's Rakam, all right, but you can't see his face. And no court in the world would count that photo as evidence.
What about the kid in the picture?
Well, that's Joseph, the kid who was shot the other night. You knew him.
Yeah. How about letting me borrow this photo, huh? Just for a day, I'll bring it back.
Sure, it's no good to me. Oh, excuse me, Rocky.
Sure.
Hello? Yeah? What's that? The Turk? Yeah? Yeah? Oh, yeah, I'll be right there. One of our reporters calling in a story. El Rakam's right-hand man, a guy named the Turk, has just been knifed in the Continental Hotel.
Really?
Yeah, you want to come down with me and take a look?
No, I'll buy a paper. Thanks for the photo, Bill. Oh, and by the way, if I should happen to run into the murderer, I'll let you know. It was after 11:30 when my taxi pulled up in front of a small sandstone apartment house on Sharia Nafar.
Ilya Renault's apartment was 2C, and it took a little while for the door to come open.
Rocky, what are you doing
here? Let me in, Ilya. I want to talk to you.
Oh, no, Rocky, I can't. I've heard on the radio the police are looking for you. If I let you come in, I would have to phone.
Ilya, listen. The police are looking for me. It's all tied in with Joseph's murder. Now, there's some things you'll want to know.
About Joseph? You found out about Joseph, Rocky?
I didn't say that. Please, let me in, Ilya.
No, but, Rocky, I'm not dressed. I've been asleep. Oh, very well. Just a moment. You may come in now. Rocky, did you have to lock it?
Ilya, I think I know why Joseph was killed.
Yes?
He was mixed up in a phony cult racket. Now, the head of this outfit is named El Rakam. He took Joseph on as one of his assistants.
El Rakam? I think I've heard Joseph mention that name.
El Rakam has been bilking the local citizens for some time now. He tells them he's giving them a new way of life or some such. In the meantime, they're giving him their dough.
And Joseph was connected with this?
Joseph was on the inside until last night. Maybe he decided to quit. I don't know. That's my guess. Rakam couldn't let him, undoubtedly, because the kid knew too much about Rakam's activities.
Then Rakam murdered my brother.
Either that or he had one of his followers do it, which is more likely. Rakam had an assistant named the Turk. I think he's our man.
The Turk? But this is the man the police say you killed, Rocky.
Right. Rakam or somebody planned it that way. They'd get rid of the Turk and me at the same time. Here, I want you to take a look at this photograph. Here.
Why, yes. Yes, it is Joseph. Rocky, who is this man in the long robes?
El Rakam.
But here, it shows clearly the gun in Rakam's hand.
No, William. It shows a man in a robe firing a gun. Another man is being shot, okay. But Rakam has his back turned.
And there is nothing.
Ilya, I think I've got a way to break Rakam. Anyway, it's worth a try.
Open in the name of the law.
Rocky, it's the police.
Shh.
Jordan, this is Sergeant Greco. I know you're in there. Open or I shall fire through the door.
You'll do it, too.
Rocky, the back door.
If you do not open the door at once, I shall shoot away the lock. Do not be a fool, Jordan. Come peacefully.
Rocky, the back door leads to an alley which will take you to the Sharia Shaba.
All right, Ilya. I'll see you later.
Do not say that I have not warned.
As Greco came through the door, I went out the window and down the alley fast. Greco yelled at me to halt, but I wasn't stopping for anything. I had a date for a showdown with a 2 o'clock man.
You are listening to The 2 o'clock Man, tonight's adventure with Rocky Jordan. The time has come for us to help the Red Cross. Great numbers of our people are suffering from the worst cold wave in 50 years, and the suffering doesn't end with the cold. You can help by contributing to the Red Cross today. Now we take you back to Cairo and tonight's adventure with Rocky Jordan, the 2 o'clock man.
Well, it was 1 o'clock when I wandered into El Rakam's temple, an hour before the big meeting, and the place was almost deserted. El Rakam's dressing room showed at the end of a dimly lit hall. I went inside and waited for him to put in an appearance. It came sooner than I expected. A few moments later, from outside the door, I heard the voice of Rakam giving instructions to a couple of his bodyguards. I ducked into the shadows so he wouldn't see me when he first came in.
You can come out from your hiding place, Jordan. I know you are here.
Yeah. Must have your own special brand of radar.
You were observed entering the temple. One of my guards has been following you all day.
Don't I bother you at all?
Why should you, Jordan? The police will find you and then you would no longer be any bother to me. Now say what you have come to say and leave.
All right, I'll say it.
You will not mind my preparing myself for tonight.
Never mind the gun, Rakam.
The gun? I was not reaching for the gun. I was going for my makeup.
Well, then, I'll just hold it if you don't mind.
It is yours, with my compliments. Now say what you have to say and go.
You're through, buddy.
That has been said to me many times before, but it has never been the case.
That's all being changed. Remember the photo of you killing a cop in Alexandria?
Oh, yes, that one again. The police have tried to prove with that once before that I was guilty of murder. But you see, it was a failure.
My face was obscured.
That's what's changed. And all because of a kid named Joseph. You see, there was another photo of you killing that cop. A photo Joseph had. But you know that, don't you? You know that Joseph had a clear picture of you killing the cop, and that's why you had to take care of the kid.
If you were finished, Jordan, go.
Well, what you don't know is that Joseph mailed that clear photo to his sister, Elia, before he was killed. She has it, and I just saw it. If you really had your boys tagging me, as you say, you know I just came from her house.
You think I'm a fool, do you not?
Look, Junior, I don't care whether you believe me or not. Sabaaya will, and that's what counts.
You're lying, Jordan. It is nothing but an attempt.
Think
to
so?
Get...
Okay, I'll show you. This telephone. You think the cops want me for murder, huh? I'll just pitch my murder rap against yours. We'll just see who the police want. Hello, Captain Sabaaya, please. Sam? Jordan? Now, wait a minute. Quiet, will you, and listen. Ilya Renault is on her way over to the station right now with Joseph's photo of Rockham's killing. Yeah. That'll give you all you want. No, I'm with him now in his dressing room at the temple. Don't worry, Sam. He's looking right into his own gun. So if you want him, come and get him. Relax, buddy. It'll be a few minutes yet.
Jordan, perhaps we could discuss this under more favorable circumstances.
Not interested in talking. I read about it in the papers.
Jordan, I am a wealthy man. Something could be arranged.
Your forehead's getting moist.
I did not kill Joseph.
He had the Turk do it, and you killed him.
That does not matter. Come, let us leave here. Let us go out.
Kind of anxious to get me to use that door, aren't you? Could it be that you got your boys out there ready to throw a knife into me when I walk out?
Jordan, this is not the place to talk. Let us step out.
And I'm laying 10-1. The first guy out that door winds up with a knife in him.
No, you are wrong.
Why don't you go out? There's nothing here for you but me with a gun. And the police are on their way.
I don't believe it. You didn't even call them. It was a fake. You would be too frightened to call the police since they are after...
Sounds like Sam, all right.
The police will never get to El Rakam. No, it is I, El Rakam, your leader, master of the Libya. Leader in the path of new light.
Well, that was it. El Rakam got it from his own men. And that was the end of his organization. Sabaaya showed up in a few moments and rounded up the knife throwers, and everything was cleared up. The Turk killed Joseph on orders. Rakam killed the Turk to set me up, and then his followers took care of him. It was a regular round robin. Sam wanted to know about the photo I told him about on the phone, and when I said it was a gag, he didn't mind. His case was closed. Well, the only unfinished business was Ilya. I went over to her place to tell her how things worked out. I guess it must have been a long story. Took me quite a while to tell it all.
CBS, again at this same time next week for another story of adventure and intrigue when we take you back to Cairo and the Cafe Tambourine run by Rocky Jordan. Jack Moyles plays the title role with tonight's story by William Frug, edited by Larry Roman and Gomer Kuhl. Rocky Jordan is produced and directed by Cliff Howell with original music by Richard Arant. Larry Thor speaking. This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.